Welcome to Electron Online. Now this problem from the JEE main test can be done rather quickly, except that it's a really long problem. There's a lot of text to read, so you probably spend half the time just reading the problem trying to figure out what they're asking for. So let's find out what they're asking for and then see how quickly we can solve this problem. It does deal with the concept of Lenz's law, and it says that a conducting bar of length L is free to slide on two parallel conducting rails as shown in the figure. They do provide the figure. Two resistors R1 and R2 are connected across the ends of the rails. There is a uniform magnetic field B pointing into the page. An external agent pulls the bar to the left at constant speed V. The correct statement about the directions of the induced currents I1 and I2 flowing through R1 and R2 respectively is, and they give us four possible answers. I1 is clockwise while I2 is counterclockwise. Both are clockwise. I1 is counterclockwise while I2 is clockwise, or both are counterclockwise. So, how do we figure this out? Well, the concept of Lenz's law is that a magnetic field will be produced that produces an induced current, but the magnetic field induced will oppose the change forced onto the existing magnetic field. Notice if we look on the left side, the magnetic field is pointing into the board. As the bar is sliding to the left, we're changing the area, we're making it smaller, so we're reducing the flux, the magnetic flux through the loop, and Lenz's law says that an induced magnetic field will be formed to oppose the change. So it's being reduced, we're trying to keep it from reducing, so we're going to add more flux into the same direction. So an induced magnetic field in the same direction will be induced as this bar sliding to the left to try and keep the flux from decreasing. On the right side, notice that the area is larger, so more and more magnetic flux will go through the loop. And of course, Lenz's law says that a magnetic field will be induced that opposes that change. Since more is added, we're trying to oppose that. So what means is we're going to induce a magnetic field in the opposite direction to keep it from increasing. So that's going to be induced magnetic field on the left side and induced magnetic field on the right side. Now we use our right hand. Notice that this is into the page, so we point our thumb into the direction of the induced magnetic field, and our fingers will curl in the direction of the current, which in this case is going to be clockwise. So that means that I1 will be clockwise, CW for clockwise. On the other hand, here we have an induced magnetic field out of the page, so we point our thumb out of the page, our fingers will curl in the direction of the induced current, which will be counterclockwise like this. So we can say that I2 will be counterclockwise, and there's the answer. Well, we have to find which answer matches what we found. So I1 is clockwise, and I2 is counterclockwise, which means that answer A is the correct answer. All other answers have therefore must be wrong. And that is how it's done. So you can see it's rather quickly done. Here we can see that the magnetic flux is decreasing, so we want to add in the same direction to keep it from decreasing. Here the magnetic flux is increasing, we want to subtract from it by going in the opposite direction to keep it from increasing. Point your thumb in the direction of the magnetic field gives you the direction of the current. Point your thumb in the direction of the magnetic field, and the fingers indicate the direction of the current, and that's how we found the answer.